New problems this morning for the government's small business bailout program.
You're a little guy, you know, chances are you're going to the back of the line.
Congress approving another $484 billion for loans after the first round of funding ran out. But new reports claim at least 75 publicly traded companies, some worth more than $100 million, cashed in on the first payout.
The intent of this was for business that needed the money.
While Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin insists those big businesses will pay that money back, Trump called out one institution in particular.
I'm not going to mention any other names, but when I saw Harvard, they have one of the largest endowments anywhere in the country, maybe in the world, I guess, and they're going to pay back that money.
But Harvard is now denying the accusation, insisting the funding it got did not come through the Paycheck Protection Program. This as new concerns surface over the application process for the program.
I was shocked and frustrated. I need to catch a break.
Officials now revealing a possible glitch caused the personal information of thousands of applicants to be leaked, compromising their social security numbers and credit data.
I've jumped through all of these hoops, and then to have to now worry about whether all of my financial information, both personally and professionally, has been compromised is really upsetting.
It comes amid a fierce debate over when it's safe for those struggling businesses to reopen.
We have to work. We have to still maintain bills, and that's just the reality of it.
One of President Trump's closest allies even voicing his concern. Senator Lindsey Graham tweeting, "I worry that our friends and neighbors in Georgia are going too fast, too soon." White House Task Force Dr. Deborah Birx insists states must meet certain criteria before lifting restrictions.
If there's a way that people can social distance and do those things, then they can do those things. I don't know how, but people are very creative.
But some state leaders argue that maintaining social distance should not be the top priority.
There are more important things than living, and that's saving this country for my children and my grandchildren, and saving this country for all of us.
Georgia and Tennessee could see stores open their doors as early as Friday, to the dismay of some local leaders.
I pray that the number of Georgians who are infected and die will not increase significantly in the coming weeks as a result of the lifting of these restrictions.
And South Carolina is working to ease restrictions despite the state failing to record 2 weeks of reduced cases.
I know I feel very uncomfortable reopening so quickly. We need to see that all of the steps that we've taken and all of this pain we've undergone is going to truly flatten the curve and keep us safe rather than potentially jumping the gun.
And in Georgia, there are new guidelines for salons and barbershops to reopen. State officials say salons should consider administering temperature checks on their employees and clients, maintain social distancing, and wear masks at all times. Kenneth, Mona.
Megan, thank you.